This one here. Shall we spend some time with that?
Yes, sure. Yeah.
X square minus 5. So the concept is the same. Let me share whiteboard. The concept is the same. Now we have the function and x square minus 5. The idea is x square minus 5 greater than or equal to 0. This is the standard structure for all square roots. Okay. You find the name. Whatever is inside the square root, you put greater than or equal to 0. Okay. Now, okay. Solving this is kind of like a quadratic inequality. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, if it was equal to, you would get plus root 5 minus root 5, right?
Yeah.
Now, since this is a greater than or equal to, the in this case domain, the set of solutions is outside the boundary of what is here, greater than root 5 and less than minus root 5. You write that as x greater than or equal to root 5, x less than or equal to minus root 5. Because the inequality is greater than or equal to from the square.
Yeah.
Look, if it is x square is equal to 5, x is equal to plus or minus root 5. But in this case, there is an inequality greater than or equal to, which makes this the solution set.
Okay.
Can I spend one more minute on something that is sort of a sidestep but related to this?
Yeah, sure.
So if this was lesser than or equal to, the solutions would be the same, okay, Ashwa, in terms of plus or minus root 5, but the solution set would be the part between root 5 and minus root 5. Okay? So how you would write this is x less than or equal to root 5, greater than or equal to minus root 5 between these two. Because the quadratic, in this case x square, is lesser than or equal to root 5.
Okay, got it.